Minor League Baseball now on the show as our road trip makes a stop in the Double-A Texas League. Ought to be a good one here between the Midland Rockhounds and the San Antonio Missions. It's baseball, it's the show, and it comes your way next. Greg Braxton will be tasked with the starting pitching assignment for the away team. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Hey, this guy has a four-pitch repertoire, right? And those are a lot of nice options to have. You can go hard, soft. You can go in and out. And anytime you have four pitches, if you can throw them for strikes, you have the big advantage.
Coming to the plate now, Bruno Perez. And we are ready for some daytime baseball. And we are underway as the first pitch of the afternoon is taken for ball one. The 1-0. A ball and a strike now. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And this one runs a little too far in, ball two. Two balls and a strike, here it is. Starts to go around here, but it doesn't matter. This is strike two anyway.
Pretty lucky to get away with that one. There's not a situation ever where you want to throw a high changeup, so I think he'll try to make an adjustment with the next one he throws.
Lofted in the air out toward right center. Robinson on the move, makes the play, one away. And with that, here's a look at the visitors' starting lineup. What's going to be the key for him today, Mark?
Taking a look at this lineup, they're going to have to work the count. That's the key to success right here. They have to find a way to drive this guy's pitch count up and get into that bullpen as quick as possible.
Settling in now, Steve Lombardozzi, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. And here's a fastball called for strike one. One out, nobody on.
Zero.
A swinging strike, and now it's 0-2.
Just reached back and threw a high fastball right by him. He didn't stand a chance.
Now the 0-2 pitch. Count remains at 0-2.
Hey, I don't mind you throwing a fastball in this situation, but I think, if we're being honest with ourselves, that one caught a little bit too much of the plate.
And he'll try to hold back, but he won't be able to, as that's ruled a swing, and there are two away now.
For me, check swings are right there next to bang-bang plays at first as the most difficult calls for an ump to make. Taking a look at show motion, the batter doesn't appear to hold up enough, so I think the call was right.
Strike one to start the at-bat. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. Hit on the ground out to short. Scooped up on the backhand. Throw will be well late as he reaches it first.
Boy, D-Row, this looked like one of those easy 1-2-3 innings. Next thing you know, a little swinging ground ball and a two-out infield base hit.
Yeah, it's never too late. You never know when a rally's going to start. It seemed innocent early on. He got two quick outs, but now we see traffic at first.
Ripped down the first base line. Here it comes, 0-2. Live, but speared on a hop. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. One hit, one left. So it's on to the bottom of inning number one. No score. Tommy Diori, a Missouri-born right-hander, gets the job of starting pitcher here. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Hey, Matt, this guy also uses that pitch that's kind of in vogue in the game now, that cutter. It looks to the hitter like a four-seam fastball, and the next thing you know, it's running in on you. Mariano Rivera used that pitch exclusively in the ninth inning and broke a lot of bats, and this guy joins a long list of guys that have added the cutter to his repertoire.
Now to the plate, Colby Trojanowski. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Chopped weakly to the left. And there's one away. And with that, here's a glance at the starting lineup for the home squad. Mark, daytime baseball at home. What do we need to know about these guys?
Well, Matty, you take a look at this lineup filled with young bloods. Just young guys, hungry, aggressive, trying to do damage and move traffic to both gaps. Line-to-line power up and down this lineup. Should be interesting to see if this pitcher uses their aggressiveness against them.
First pitch on its way. Way out in front. He's ready. Here's the 0-1. A swing and a ground ball to third. And that's the second out.
Batting third.
Digging in the switch hitter, Lester Canale. He'll swing it from the left side right here. Here's the first pitch to him. Grounded to short. Cordero is there. Throw in time, and the side is retired. An inning in the books. No score here on the show. Now at the plate, Garrett Angel, as it'll be 5, 6, and 7 due up to kick off the second inning. And he fouls this one off. The windup and the 0-1. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. On its way, the 0-2 pitch. Fouled off.
Batter's going to have to find a way to regroup right there. That caught too much of the plate. He knew it. He missed it. He might not get another opportunity to put the ball in play.
And he's caught looking at a beautiful curveball there as that buckled him for the first out of the inning.
Time for a look at the defensive alignment for the home team. And one of the main backbones for them out on the field today is the guy behind the dish. He controls the entire flow of the game, manipulates a pitching staff, gets them through the game, and not only that, completely shuts down a running game.
Count even now at 1-1. Hit on the ground down the first baseline, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. The 1-2 is a wave and a miss. He struck him out.
Boy, there's nothing better from a pitcher standpoint than watching that high fastball, a high piece of cheese swung at and missed. That pitch looks so inviting to hit, but it's awfully tough to put in play.
Tried to check it, and it's 0-1. We'll attempt to put the ball in play for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. Sends one in the air, deep down the right field line. And that nearly broke our scoreless tie. Instead, it's a foul ball.
Hey, I don't blame him for fouling that one away. His eyes lit up right there. He did not expect a changeup up in the zone with two strikes. Gotta regroup.
He checks his swing. Did he go around? No, says third base umpire Rusty Valentine. Ball one. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Fouled away. The 1-2 is in there. A called strike three. Three up, three down, three strikeouts. Not too shabby. Through an inning and a half, no score on the show. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Willis Robinson. He'll get to take his first cuts here. First pitch of the at-bat. Pulled toward right center field. Atwood is to his left as he puts it away in the alley for the first out of the inning.
All right, here's how the visitors are lining up today. And you talked about fitting a profile for a right fielder. Big surprise who brings the absolute bazooka to the game today. That is the right fielder. Don't look for anyone to test this guy.
Hit back up the middle. And that'll get on through into center, and he's got himself a one-out hit.
Hey, guys, he was obviously trying to bury that slider down in there. Nice execution by the batter right there. Keeping his hands inside, fighting it off for a nice base hit.
In now, Cedric Abercrombie, as he rips it on the ground to second. Oh, what a stop on the slide. Takes it himself, and he got him. Well, he'll put this in his pocket and be content with just the one out.
Designated hitter,
To the plate now is the designated hitter, Luis Ibarra. First delivery to him on the way. Left side, but well fouled. Line down the left field line. But this is going to get foul.
He wasn't fooling anybody with that fastball. He barreled it up nice right there. He's just got to find a way to keep it fair.
To short. Scooped up. On to second for the force out, and the side is retired. So no runs on a hit here. No errors. One man left on. We played two full, and we are tied nothing nothing. And here now is Dustin Garneau. He starts off the inning against a guy who struck out the side last inning. How did they get to him here?
I'm not sure, Matt, that they want to stay as patient. He's been throwing a lot of strikes. They might want to start swinging a little bit earlier in the count.
Fastball called for strike two. Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning. Digging in, Barry White. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. This is on the ground over to first. And he'll step on first himself for the out. Ready for another chance? Bruno Perez, 0 for 1 here in the early going. First offering on its way. And a fastball just a bit high. This is in the air to center. Does he have another 1-2-3 for the ledger? He does. Seven in a row he set down now as the side is retired. Stepping into the box, Lee Tan. He'll start things out here in a tie ball game.
Lee Tan.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. Softly hit out to short. Throws in time, and that's out number one.
Batting ninth. Catcher.
Standing in, Daryl Mayer, as the switch hitter will take his cuts left-handed here. Well hit the other way, and it's into the gap. And he is in at second base with a one-out double.
The left fielder, number 30, Colby.
Digging in to try it again, Colby Trojanowski. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. First pitch coming, here it is. Grounded back up the middle. And that'll get by into center field for a base hit. And the runner from second will stay put at third, so they're runners at the corners now with one away.
Yeah, I don't know if I love the approach of pulling the trigger on that 0-0 pitch. I can't imagine that's exactly what he's looking for. The result works. Pitcher can't be too mad.
Line drive to center field. In there. Base hit, and that ought to get the run in from third.
Boy, that has to feel good as a hitter, D-Row. You get that base hit to give your team the lead. You have to feel good when you get down to first base.
Yeah, it's just a nice approach. You see him turn to his boys right there and get fired up with the dugout. 100%. Not trying to do too much. Able to quiet the moment down, center himself, and come through in a big spot.
Into the box now, Lester Canales. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Line drive to left. That's in there. Base hit. Throw comes in quickly here, and that'll prevent the runner at third from testing things here.
Boy, there's a bullet base hit right there, but you have to hold there, D-Row, to make sure that gets through and isn't caught for a line drive double play.
Yeah, you have to play the game right there and respect the infield and respect the line drive. I know he wants to get a ribby for his buddy.
Meanwhile, this ball gets down. It's a base hit. One run is scored.
Hey, guys, I like the execution by the batter there. He got a hanger in the middle of the plate. He could have come unglued, but he didn't. He stayed focused and drove a line drive base hit.
Into the box, Miguel Miranda hit down the third baseline. And this scoots under his glove. Oh, what a time for that. One run scored. And he's out on a strong throw.
Now batting, second baseman.
Digging in for his second at bat, Cedric Abercrombie. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Liner towards second. And that's in there. Base hit.
I mean, there's no secret right now. There's a fight at the bat rack. Everybody wants up at the plate right now. They're feeling frisky. They're all pulling the trigger early, and it's working.
Stepping in now, Luis Ibarra. He swings, and it's a line drive to left center. And that finds the outfield grass for a base hit. And a good throw will wind up holding that runner at third, so the bases become loaded now with two gone.
You're seeing this lineup, eyes light up, and this guy's missing over the heart of the plate. Not only is he missing over the heart of the plate, he's missing up. That's an excellent job right there to make him pay once again.
Standing in now, Lee Tan, as he hits one on a line to left field. Perez is there, and he puts it away to stop the bleeding. So four score in the inning, but it could have been much, much worse as they wind up leaving the bases loaded. Three innings complete. The Missions lead it 4-0. Riding in once again, Steve Lombardozzi. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Lots of baseball.
There's a swing and a ball hit in the air, and a ball that he got every stitch of, as that one, without a doubt, is gone.
Oh!
So a solo shot down the line in left. As they get on the board, it's 4-1 now.
As soon as this thing left the bat, you knew it had the distance to get out of here. The only question was whether it was going to stay fair or not. And that question was answered with a resounding doink as it caromed off the foul pole for a homer.
Into the box now, Eric Cordero. Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball. Base is empty here with nobody out. Popped him up. Canales has a play, looks it into his glove, and there's one gone.
Now batting, Kyle.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Kyle Atwood. One run in and one gone so far this inning. And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1.
You know, Matty, when I first broke into the league, you wouldn't see that high heater first pitch right out of the gate. But I think there's been a change in philosophy here. Back in the late 90s, early 2000s, guys wanted to attack you more east-west, get you leaning left-right. Now you're seeing guys attack in the philosophy more north-south. Just with launch angles and exit velocities, I think guys are afraid to throw that sinking fastball for fear that guys are just going to run their barrel into it. Not the case with the high fastball.
It's a swinging bunt up the line. That winds up foul for the second strike. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two.
This inning didn't get started the way he'd hoped with that home run, but I've got to give him credit for flushing it and coming back here to get strikeouts on the last two guys. He's acting like it didn't even happen before.
Fastball in there for a called strike. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Just a bit jumpy that time, swung on and missed.
Hey, nice job of bouncing back after the leadoff homer. Two quick outs after the bomb, and he's got a chance to get out of this.
Can't get him to chase. It's 1-2. Swing and a ball popped high in the air and heading for foul territory behind first. Canales is there to make the catch, and the side is retired. but not before they're able to at least get one back on the solo home run. Bottom of the fourth coming up. San Antonio's out in front, 4-1. At the plate, Daryl Mayer. And Dan, I'm sure the starter on the mound would like to hit the rewind button on that last inning.
Oh, no doubt about that, Mac. That was a really rocky frame, but clearly not enough to chase him from this game. We'll see if he's still shaking a bit or if he's able to put this behind him.
That's through for a base hit. He's now 2-for-2 in this one. So a leadoff base hit out of the ninth spot, and that sets the top of the order up nicely here to start the inning.
Even though that pitcher was able to execute in off the plate, batter was able to keep his hands inside that baseball and drive it up the middle.
Into the box, Colby Trojanowski rounded down the third baseline. Lombardozzi, the relay, not in time as he beats the throw by a step.
Now batting, the shortstop.
Digging in and looking for more, Ryan Benjamin. He singled his last time up. First pitch coming, here it is. Lifted in the air toward the line and right. But no chance to run it down. It's a foul ball. On its way, the 0-1 pitch. And they pitch out here, but nothing's going on. The 1-1. A ground ball to third, and they could get two. The second for one, relay to first in time, and just like that, this side is retired. Around the horn they go, 5-4-3 to end the threat. The three of us are back after this message and a word from our local stations. Leading off the inning, DeAndre Tapia, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one.
We're moving along in this one, heading into the middle innings. This guy continuing to pitch well, and one of the reasons why, first pitch strike ratio over 70% up to this point in this game.
Slapped hard the opposite way, and that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit, so there'll be a man aboard here to start out their half of the fifth, and he's going to get to second now with nobody out.
Definitely tried to elevate the heater right there with two strikes, but caught way too much of the plate. Nice execution by the hitter.
No balls and a strike to count. Fastball, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2.
Hey, you find yourself down 0-2, you've got to grind a little bit right here. I don't understand the game plan. Let's see if we can get this one back to even count.
Bounce to first. Canale takes it in. And he'll reach first as they can't make the play on him. Digging in now, Dustin Garneau, and their runners at the corners now. And that's high for a ball, 1-0.
With the infield back and a runner at third, he's definitely pitching for a strikeout or maybe something like a harmless pop-up. You can see it from that high fastball, but that was just a good job of laying off that pitch.
A ball and two strikes now. Just inside, not by much. It's 2-2. Fifth inning here in a 4-1 ball game. Grounder down the line at third. Played on the backhand. And not in time as the run scores. Now at the plate, Barry White. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. Comes the 0-2 pitch. One ball. That was a curveball that never really broke, stayed high.
That curveball is a pitch you have to get on top of, or else it'll take off just like that one did.
And he takes strike three called on the fastball. One gone.
Now back.
Now back to the top of the lineup. Stepping in, Bruno Perez. He flew out in his last at bat. One ball, no strikes to count. A 1-0 delivery. And a neck high fastball that time.
Well, I know the last thing he wants to do is load the bases right here, so the pressure is on right now to get back in the strike zone.
Robinson comes on now and makes the catch in shallow center for round number two. Trying to pick things up where he left off, Steve Lombardozzi, who went deep last time up. First pitch of the at-bat. Takes a look at one catching the outside corner. Here's the 0-1. Behind 0-2 now. Nothing in two count, and the pitch towards second. And that's through into right field for a base hit. The runner from second crosses the plate.
Boy, so frustrating as a pitcher. Two-strike RBI base hit. The ball wasn't hit very hard, D-Ro, but from a hitter's perspective, you'll take it any way you can get it.
Yeah, in today's day and age where everyone's looking to go deep and can go deep, not many guys have a legitimate two-strike approach. This is one of those players, and that's exactly what he did. Shortened his stroke a little bit, didn't try and do too much, and came through for the team.
That's a great take right there. You knew the pitcher was going to try and expand the zone 0-2 in a big spot, and he was able to spit on that one, hopefully get something in the heart to plate this pitch.
And another foul ball. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Calling for it, Trojanowski. He's got it to end the inning as they'll strand the tying run in scoring position. So it's two runs on two hits, no errors, and two men left on base. Last half of the fifth coming up. The Missions lead it 4-3. Ready once again, Lester Canales.
Leading off for the Missions, third baseman, Lester.
Here comes Canales. The first pitch. Line towards center field, and that's in for his second hit of the afternoon. So the leadoff man reaches in their half of the fifth. Digging in once again, Willis Robinson. He came through with an RBI single in his last at-bat. From the stretch, here's the pitch. Line drive to left, and that'll get down for a base hit.
Now batting, third baseman.
At the plate, Miguel Miranda. Two base hits, both singles to this point. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Oh, a double play ball to second. 4-6-3, and they turn the double play.
Well, there's the pitcher's best friend right there. The inning was off to a rough start, right? But nothing changes that like a good old two ball. We'll see if they can strand the runner at third now.
Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. Left side, Angel fields it cleanly. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. So they pick up no runs on two base hits, no errors, and one man left on base. Five innings complete. San Antonio's out in front, 4-3. Leading off the inning, Kyle Atwood, and they'll need him to get something going here. And a fastball is in there for strike one. The windup and the 0-1. The high fastball is in there. So two pitches in a row on the outside corner for strikes. You think he stays out there?
I think he does. One thing you don't want to do, though, Matt, it's not a good idea to throw the same hitter, the same pitch three times in a row, back to back to back. But I think he might throw it here.
Got him to go down swinging there. Kyle Atwood goes down to become the first out in the sixth inning. No balls and one strike. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-1. And it's fouled away. 4-3 our score here as we play inning number six. Struck him out, and he becomes the ninth strikeout victim thus far.
Good heater to strike him out there, and he looks absolutely locked in to start this inning. That's back-to-back punch-outs on only six pitches.
A swing and a miss just out in front of that fastball.
Oh, man, he's got a chance to strike out the side on nine pitches. Seven down, two to go.
This is hit the other way out toward left field. In there, a base hit. So we'll go at least one at-bat deeper into the top of the sixth after that two-out success.
Boy, D-Row, the pitch count keeps climbing and climbing and climbing, and this is another example of they're really making this guy work in this one.
Yeah, that's the grind right here. You put your hard hat on, you try and find a way to get into that bullpen.
Ball one to start the at-bat. Back up the middle. And the inning will continue as that's through for a two-out hit.
Hey, after back-to-back two-out hits right now, this pitcher thought he was going to cruise through this inning, and now he's got traffic, and he's in jeopardy with a ball in the gap or a ball missed over the heart of the plate, a crooked number going on the board.
And he fouls this one off. Trying to hold the lead, here's the delivery. Stays alive, still 0-2. Tapia on second, Hernandez on at first with two down to 1-2 now. And he will strike him out. 10 now in the ball game, and the inning is over.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for Midland, number 6.
Ready for another shot now, Luis Ibarra.
Leading off for the mission.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. He's around first, heading for two. And this will find the wall out near the visitor's bullpen. The relay throw, and he'll get there as he legs out the leadoff triple.
That was not the way this pitcher envisioned the beginning of the game. Going for him wasn't that bad of a pitch. He jumps all over it. Nobody can run it down, and he's standing at third feeling pretty good about himself.
In now, Lee Tan, lifted in the air out towards left center. Catch made in center. Here comes the runner from third. And the run is in to score from third. Now a 5-3 game.
Great job of offensive execution there. Leadoff triple, and then the sac fly to bring home a run.
From the stretch. High in the air out towards shallow right. Hernandez has a beat on it, and that's the second out of the inning.
The left fielder, number Irby. Colby.
Ready once again, Colby Trojanowski. Ready to deliver, here's the first pitch. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Hernandez over to his right, and that's the third out. So it's one run, one hit, no errors, and no one left. Seventh inning coming up. The Missions lead it 5-3. Back here on the show. Seventh inning straight ahead, but first let's take a look at the game summary for the first six innings of baseball. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Barry White. He'll be tasked with starting things as we begin the seventh.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop and a blast? They could certainly use that right now.
Pitch on the way. And this catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now.
Let's see if he continues to climb that ladder. Or does he try and get him fishing on something bouncing in the dirt?
And he'll try to get him to chase the fastball there, but he lays off. 1-2. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. And that misses 2-2.
Keep in mind, people, the longer the at-bat, the higher the likelihood that this becomes his last inning.
And he struck him out. And there's strikeout number 11 in the ballgame.
How about it?
Now back to the top of the lineup. Stepping in, Bruno Perez.
The bottom third of the lineup hasn't put up a lot of resistance in this one. Pretty much has been sure outs other than that one hit. That really puts a lot of pressure on other guys to make stuff happen. These aren't the guys you usually count on, but it certainly helps if they can do something productive.
And this will be taken in by the third baseman for the second out. Striding in once again, Steve Lombardozzi. Tried to check it, and it's 0-1.
The guy in the mound is having one heck of a night, but the downside of that, if you're going to strike out a lot of guys, your pitch count is going to be high, so
This gives the offense some kind of hope as this game's getting down to the end.
Trojanowski sprinting after it, and that retires the side. So no runs, no hits, no errors, and no one left. On now to the bottom of inning number 7. San Antonio's out in front, 5-3. Kevin Hurd gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home 7. Digging in to try it again, Ryan Benjamin. First delivery to him on the way. Swinging a soft liner, leaps high as he makes the catch. Well done.
Off the bat, that had soft base hit written all over it. But a nice snag there by the infielder on that soft liner that could have been a potential base hit.
Pitch on the way. Hit on the ground to short. Throw gets him, 2 down. Digging in and looking for more, Willis Robinson. Here comes the first pitch. Driven down the left field line. Will it stay fair? It will not. Just slicing foul at the very last moment. So close to extra bases. Ripped down the line. But this will wind up a foul ball, strike 2.
He was able to foul that one off, but you could tell he was definitely late. That breaking ball, the pitch before that heater right there, definitely threw his timing off.
Atwood giving chase. He's there to make the play, and that'll retire the side. Leading off the inning, Eric Cordero, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up. Watches a fastball right there for strike 1. 0-1 count and the pitch. And this ball's pretty well struck high and deep to left field. Gone to lead off the inning. A solo shot here to left as they pull within 1 here. It's now a 5-4 game.
Well, that ball right there was right up in the happy zone. It doesn't take much to drive one out of the ballpark when you connect on a high pitch like that. The backspin carried that one right out of here.
Trojanowski has a read on it, and he hauls it in for the first out of the inning. Digging in once again, Garrett Angel. He got called out on strikes his last time through. And he takes ball 1. The 1-0. This is line to left. But pretty much right at the left fielder as he takes it in for the 2nd out.
How about it?
Ready for another chance? DeAndre Tapia. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Fouled off. 2 out, nobody on. There's a swing and a high deep drive headed for the right field corner. And a big sigh of relief on the mound as that nearly tied it, but this ball is foul. Pulled high in the air out to right field. Tan is there and he'll make the catch to retire the side. But the damage is done as thanks to the solo home run, this is now a 1-run game. Home half of the 8th straight ahead. The Missions lead it 5-4. Digging in, Miguel Miranda. First pitch of the at-bat. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Atwood is in pursuit. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning. Now at the plate, Cedric Abercrombie. First pitch coming, here it is. Liner towards second. He lays out, but he can't make the play, and it's through into right. To the plate now is the designated hitter, Luis Ibarra. First pitch on its way. Hit out towards second. Backhanded. He'll go to the bag for 1. On to first as the they get the double play to get him out of the inning. No runs on a hit, no errors, and no one left. Ninth inning coming up. San Antonio's out in front, 5-4. Striding in to start the ninth, Ramon Hernandez, and they'll need him to get something going here. Ready with the first pitch, here it comes. Fouled away. Here it comes. Outside for a ball, one and one. 1-1. His fastball taken high for a ball.
Great job to be able to lay off that pitch right there. You could tell the minute it came out of his hand, his eyes lit up at the plate.
Early swing there as he pulls it foul to the right side. And a swing and a miss on the fastball, and there's the first out here in the ninth. And here now is Dustin Garneau. Now here's the pitch. And he lays off there, 1-0. Bases are empty, one man out. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Popped him up. Abercrombie ranges back and he has it for out number two. Ready now, Barry White. Third baseman hugging the line here. Now the first pitch. And this ball swung on and hit to center field, and this should do it. Robinson is there to make the catch, and with that, the ball game is over.
Well, I got to be honest. I didn't think he had nine innings in him. But he battled, and he finished the game, and he picked up the win along the way, too.
A one-run finish today, 5-4, the final score. The Missions led this game from the third inning on and never wavered. Greg Braxton earns the victory on the mound. So that's it for us this afternoon. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vaskersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, log on to theshownation.com.
Fans, our final line score, first for the victorious Mission. 5 runs on 14 hits. No errors. 11, 7 men on base.
Well, I'm fixing to go in a little bit. Yeah, I'm gonna go watch baseball. I'm waving at 4.